Some of Australia's most powerful political and media identities have come together to pay tribute tonight to the Ten Network's Paul Bongiorno. Now, rivals put aside their differences to mark Bonge's 25 years in the Canberra Press Gallery at a function at Parliament House.
What really stands out with Bonge is his decency as a human being.
He's kept the respect of his peers and the affection of the public.
Here I spoke with the man himself. Paul Bongiorno, congratulations and thanks for giving us some of your time tonight. It's often said that journalists and politicians are among the least trusted professions in the world. You seem to have combined both and still a few people trust you. How did you manage to do that?
Well, I'm glad you think so, Hamish. Yeah, it is true, and I'm not exactly sure, except that what politicians do is make decisions, make policies, do things that affect virtually everybody in the nation one way or another. And journalists, of course, interpret and report on that. And that can often cause people to blame the messenger in the case of journalists rather than to blame the real culprits. But that's not to say that journalists sometimes can get it wrong, something we all have to guard against.
Bonge, I know that life in the press gallery is famously pretty bruising. One of your oldest friends, Peter Harvey, passed away recently. Did that give you pause for thought about committing your life in the same way to a pretty unforgiving profession?
Well, there's two points, I guess, to make there, Hamish. And one is, as my wife reminded me, Peter Harvey and I are virtually twins. He was 2 weeks older than me. He, of course, was diagnosed with his cancer while he and Anne, his wife, were on holiday in Venice. So Judith is saying to me that maybe we should go on a long holiday. Time may be running out. So there is that issue to it. But let me go back to the other point of your question, and that is the job itself. I've got to say to you, it's been a huge, an enormous privilege to be reporting on federal politics for so long. You're really at the heart of our democracy with all its glory and its glamour and with all its toxicity.
Bonge, you've seen 15 leadership changes, 8 elections, 5 prime ministers. I noticed that your hair's not quite as big anymore. But has, do you think, our democracy changed irreversibly in that time?
Well, look, no, I think one of the good things about Australia's democracy, we are a mature democracy, one of the oldest in the world, even though we're one of the younger countries, although there are plenty younger than us these days. So our democracy is robust and there are no holds barred. But the good thing about it is both sides of our politics accept the basics. We accept that the clearinghouse for the ideas and for the conflict is words in a parliament, not at the end of a bayonet or a knife or a bullet.
Paul Bongiorno, congratulations on a quarter of a century in the press gallery and thanks for your time tonight.
Thanks, Hamish.
Hope you enjoyed the party.